Hello, Mr. Hypes here, reporting from home. Well, not my home exactly. I don't live in this chicken coop, but my chickens do. Anyway, today we're going to be doing a Thanksgiving theme drawing. So rest easy, little chickens. It's turkey season. You're safe for now.
Ow.
In addition to this drawing being Thanksgiving themed, it's also going to use the cross contour skills that we practiced with last week. But before we start a new drawing, we got to take a second to shout out some of the drawings from last week. The first shout out goes to Clark. You killed it with the sinkhole. Next shout out goes to Jasmine. Awesome work on the vase. The donut and the bowl look especially good. Shout out to Raylan. Another large bowl drawn straight up and confidently in pen. Lillian also went straight at it with the pen, drawing all subjects accurately and with great style. Shout out to Will for neat, accurately curving lines to make those subjects look 3D. And our final shout out goes to Aubrey. Beautifully drawn subjects in blue pen. Aubrey even nailed the most difficult challenge, the dreaded cross contour donut. Awesome, awesome drawings from last week. Let's go inside and get started on our drawing challenge for this week. The drawing challenge for this week is inspired by the classic Thanksgiving meal, like the one seen in this famous painting by Norman Rockwell. This scene sets us up with some nice forms. Forms we can practice our cross contour skills on, like a flat rectangular table, cylindrical cups, and spherical dressing balls and drumsticks. Start off by drawing a tablecloth towards the bottom of the page. Put some ruffles in the bottom of the tablecloth and then a straight line at the top where the cloth folds onto the top of the table. Something like that. Then above that line, we're going to draw the turkey. A turkey consists of three shapes: the drumstick, the wing, and then the body or the breast meat around the top. I'm going to draw the drumstick first, connecting down into the thigh. Add the wing and a half circle to finish off the turkey. And then, of course, put the turkey on a plate. The next object on our table is going to be a glass of sparkling grape juice. This is a great form to practice cylinders and a bit of a sphere at the top of the glass as well. So take your time, draw a nice symmetrical trumpet shape. And our third and final subject on the table will be a can of cranberry sauce. There is no better subject to practice your cylindrical drawing skills than on a can of cranberry sauce. So I'm going to get a little bit fancy with this and draw some of the coin-shaped slices of cranberry sauce, and then a nice big cylinder of cranberry sauce, and then put that on a plate just like we did the turkey. I'm going to add a little rim to those plates to give it just a little bit of detail. And then the final thing we need for the outline portion of the drawing is the horizon line at the back end of the table. With all of our shapes drawn, we are now ready to trick these shapes out with our cross contour skills. So you just go in and you ask yourself a question. Is it a flat surface, a cylindrical surface, or a spherical surface? And then you draw the right types of lines for that surface. The tops of the slices of cranberry sauce are flat, so they get straight marks. The sides of them and the sides of the tube of cranberry sauce are cylindrical, so they will get curved marks and also straight marks going down the length of the cranberry sauce. The plate is pretty much flat, so I'm putting some straight marks, but some curved marks on the rim of the plate. The top of the glass is essentially a sphere, so it's going to have a straight line in the middle, and then lines curving in opposite directions on either side. The lines will converge down into the stem of the glass, and then the lines will curve upwards on the inside and downwards on the outside. As you move down the glass, it becomes a cylinder, and then a flat radiating shape at the bottom. The turkey is pretty much made up of three funky shaped spheres. Start by finding the hemispheres of each of the spheres. That's just the line that's halfway down the middle. And then go on either side of that line with lines that curve away from it. For the drumsticks, it will kind of become a cylinder on the end of it. Just make sure that those curves switch directions on either side of that straight line. Keep them curving all the way to the edge, curving more and more. Do not allow those curves to flatten out. They should get curvier and curvier as they move towards the edge. A few straight hatch marks on the plate, some little curving ones on the rim, and all of our objects are done. The only cross contour work we have left to do is on the tablecloth itself. For the skirt of the tablecloth, start by drawing a curving line that runs parallel to the bottom edge of the tablecloth. Have the horizontal lines gradually flatten out as they move towards the top of the table. The vertical lines can just run down vertical, but they can be kind of loose and wavy. For the top part of the table, we're going to use some one-point perspective. So put a vanishing point, or imagine a vanishing point, towards the top of the page. Then come off of those vertical lines and have them move across the top of the table, angling towards that point. That's going to make the table look like it's going off into the distance and give a real cool 3D perspective to this drawing. For the horizontal lines, start with them being pretty widely spaced. And then as they move back towards the back edge of the table, they should get closer and closer together. This will complete that illusion of 3D space. I tried to draw a cheery Thanksgiving message at the top, but I ran out of room. So I had to break out the Sharpie. And I know this is a drawing, not a landscape painting, but I'm going to go ahead and use a Bob Ross saying anyway. The fact that I messed up that text ended up being a happy accident, because I think it gave it a cool kind of trippy outer space cyber Thanksgiving vibe. Anyway, if you have a black marker, you might black out the top and bottom to kind of make the drawing in the middle pop. Happy Thanksgiving, happy drawing. Can't wait to see your all's drawings. Remember, submit them in Google Classroom by Tuesday.